Amalia, do you belong to a Lonely Hearts Club?
I've never done that sort of thing. I used to read the advertisements in the papers.
Who doesn't? Young man wants young lady wants young man.
But I never took them seriously, Alona. Until one day, I saw his advertisement. Even then, I tried not to answer it. But it kept calling out to me.
He could be 75.
The advertisement said young man.
But you never even asked for a photograph?
I don't know his name or what he looks like, but I have a much more certain guide. I can tell exactly what he looks like inside. When I undertook this correspondence, little did I know I'd grow so fond. Little did I know our views would so correspond. He writes me what his feelings are, unsure, Flaubert, Chopin, Renoir. The more I read, the more I find we're one in mind and heart. I know the kind of home we'd share, the books, the prints, the music there. A home, a life that's warm and full and rich in love and art. I don't need to see his handsome profile. I don't need to see his manly frame. All I need to know is in each letter, each one revealing later, I couldn't know him better if I knew his name. Oh, I know him so well, Alona. I know he's a very successful person, and he's terribly well educated. He's gentle and kind, soft-spoken. I know all this about him and so much more. It's just that I never met him, that's all.
If he isn't too handsome, true, it doesn't much matter. But his personal habits are more important than his looks. Supposing he snores like a locomotive, supposing he grinds his teeth, supposing he's a knuckle-cracker, Amalia, good luck with your books. And another small detail that you haven't yet mentioned. I am speaking of sex, dear, when you and he are all alone. Come to think of it, maybe you're right, maybe it doesn't matter at that. Maybe I do much better myself with a library card and a gramophone.
I don't need to see his handsome profile.
I was taken in by some.